students, welcome to Plus 2 Computer class. So you know we are discussing about our chapter called Relational Algebra and Database Management System. So in this section we are discussing about Relational Algebra. Relational Algebra means operations on relations. So in the previous video we already discussed two operations like select and project operation. So four more operations are remaining. We will start with other operations. Okay, so in the previous video we learned about select operation and project operation. Select operation means extracting tuples from a relation, that is known as select operation. Then project operation, what is meant by project operation? Project operation is used for extracting attributes from a relation. We are not extracting the entire table, we are extracting the information required for our purpose. Okay, so that we already seen from the previous video. Then in this section we are going to discuss some other operations of relational algebra. Some other operations on relational algebra. So here we are going to discuss first one is union operation, then intersection operation, third one set difference, and fourth one Cartesian product operation. Okay, these are the four operations that we are going to discuss in this video. Okay, so can we start? Yes, we will start with the table. So here already two table is given. First table is arts table and second one is sports table. So here I am displaying two relations. First table means it is arts table. The name of this table is arts and name of this table is sports. Okay, so two tables, arts and sports. In these two tables, you can identify the number of tuples and also number of attributes present in this relation. Number of rows. Okay, in this we are not including the first row because it is noted as a name. That means it is only used for naming purpose. So we are not using that. Then you look at the other rows. First row, second row, third, fourth, fifth and sixth. So six. Then here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 rows, and in both the column what is the number of attribute? 3. Okay, then especially when we are performing union, intersection, set difference or Cartesian product, whatever operation is that, first one is you want to check whether the two relations are compatible or not. Okay, what does that word indicate? Compatible or not. Compatible means the two tables or the two relations should be same in the number of columns. That means both the relations have same number of columns. That is known as compatibility. We are checking whether these two relations are ready for union operation, intersection or the other operations. Then only we can perform this kind of operations. So first, number of rows may be different. In this two column, first column, the number of row, number of tuples is equal to 6. And in the second relation, number of tables is equal to 7. Okay, so this is row, any number of rows will be there. But the structure of the design should be same. The structure means it contains three attributes. So when we combine first table with the second table, then definitely the number of rows, the number of columns you want to identify. Number of columns, here the two tables are having same number of columns. So we can easily perform a relational algebra operations. So the first operation is union operation. Okay, so what is our first operation? Union operation. So in union operation, the symbol used for representing union operation is U. Okay, U, that means union. Union operation is a binary operation. Okay, union operation is a binary operation. That means it requires minimum two operands. Okay, it requires minimum two operands. That's why it is known as union operation. Clear? Then the symbol that we are using for representing union operation is U. Then next one, suppose I am going to combine arts and sports together. Arts relation and sports relation together. So we can write like this. Arts union sports. Arts union sports. Then I already mentioned it is a binary operation. Binary operation means it requires two operands. So instead of operands, here we are using relations or tables. Okay, here we are using relations or table, arts, union, sports. Then union operation indicate we are combining two relations together by avoiding the duplicate values. Okay, what we are avoiding? We are avoiding the duplicate values. Then please look at the first two table. In this two table, there are three rows are common. First one, Fatima present in arts relation and also in sports relation. Then second one, Joseph also present in first relation and also second relation. Then third one, Vivek present in first relation and also second relation. So that means in these two relation, three rows are common. Okay, that means it is repeating. So when we are combining arts and sports together, so the total number of columns and total number of rows for arts is 6. Then total number of columns for sports is equal to 7. So that means the total number of columns, the total number of columns should be, it will be the value, it should be 30. 6 plus 7, definitely it will be 30. But when we write, what will happen is this, we will get the entire table from the first relation. That will definitely come. Then after, as a 7th column, Rahul will come. 8, Fatima will not come because it is already present in the first table. Then Nelson will come. 8. Then Joseph will not come, it's present. Then Binsi and also Regina will come. That means it is avoiding the duplicate value. So using union operation, we can combine two relations together by avoiding duplicate values. So that operation is known as union operation. So the exact definition for union operation is that union operation is a binary operation and it returns a relation containing all tuples either appearing in either or both of two specified relations. And it is denoted by the symbol U. The two relations must be union compatible. That I already mentioned. The two relations should be union compatible. Then, and the schema of the result is defined to be identical to the schema of the first relation. That means the first relation structure and the second relation structure should be same. That means same number of attribute and same attribute. Look at the two columns, two relations. In both the relation, the column names should be same. Okay, then if the two relations are union compatible, then they have same number of attributes. Then they have same number of attributes. Okay, I think the concept is clear. The resultant relation should be in your textbook. Okay, so that's why no space. That's why I'm not drawing this. First table definitely will be there. Then the other rows that is not present in the first relation that will come. So union is used for combining two relations. Okay, by combining two relations. And we can avoid the loop. That means repeated value we can avoid. Values we are not avoiding that value. But two times we are not specifying that value. Only one time we are specifying that value. Then the symbol that we are using for union compatible is U. Clear? So this is the first operation. What is the first operation? Union operation. Then next operation is intersection operation. Intersection operation. Intersection operation represented by this symbol. N, that means just opposite of union symbol. Intersection means the rows that is present in both the relations. Okay, the rows that is present in, that means common to all, both the relations. The rows that is common to both the relations are present in intersection. So we can find out the relation common to the arts relation and sports relation. Okay, what are the tuples that is common in arts and also sports relation? First one, Fatima. Fatima present in arts and also sports. Second one, Joseph also present in arts and also sports. And third one is Vivek. Okay, so these three columns, when we write arts, intersection, sports. Okay, when we write arts, intersection, sports, then we will get the rows that is present in both the relation. Fatima, Joseph and Vivek. These three rows will come as the resultant relation or as a resultant table. Okay, I think it is clear. So it will come. That means both the relations will be present. Both, that means the relations or the tuples, tuples present in both the relations. So three rows we will get when we write arts, intersection, sports. So the definition of intersection is that intersection operation is also a binary operation. It is also a binary operation and it returns a relation containing the tuples appearing in both the relations. Okay, appearing in both the relation, and it is represented by the symbol intersection symbol. Okay, we are discussing this intersection and union in sets and max. Okay, your plus one first chapter sets. In that we are using cross product, union operation, intersection operation. Okay, this is similar to that kind of operation because it is relational algebra. Definitely some terms in mathematics also we are using here. Okay, then so that is our second operation, intersection operation, and it is used to the symbol intersection symbol. Okay, clear? Then in intersection symbol also or intersection operation also, you want to check whether the two tables are union compactable or not. Union compactable or not. That means the schema should be same and also the number of attributes should be similar. Okay, so that is our second operation, intersection operation. Then third operation is set difference. Third operation is set difference operation. Set difference operation means, and it is denoted by the symbol minus. Set difference we are using by using the symbol minus symbol. Minus symbol we are using for representing set difference. Set difference also a binary operation and it returns a relation containing the tuples appearing in the first relation but not in the second relation. So when we write arts minus sports, okay, when we write arts minus sports, then we will get all the tuples present in the first relation but not in the second relation. So what will be the values? Sachin present in arts relation but not in the first relation. So the first value will be Sachin and second one will be Nikita and third one will be Nivin, because all these three rows are not present in the second relation. Okay, the rows or the tuples present in the first relation but not in the second relation will come. So which are the tuples that is present in the first relation? Sachin, Nikita and Nivin. These three relations are present in the first table but not in the second. Then if we write just opposite, sports minus arts. Sports minus arts. Then we will get Rahul will come because Rahul will be in the first relation but not in the second relation. Then Nelson, it is in the first relation but not in the second relation. Then after that, Binsi, in the first relation but not in the second relation. And Regina also will come in the first relation but not in the second relation. Okay, so these are the answers for set difference, arts minus sports and sports minus arts. Clear? So this is very common because it's very easy to identify the relations in the first relation, but the tuples in the first relation but not in the second relation is known as set difference. Okay, I think it is clear, concept is clear too. Then one more relation is present, that is Cartesian product operation. Cartesian product. Cartesian product operation. Cartesian product operation means cross product. We are combining all the tables together. Okay, all the tables together. But we need a special or one need a common row that should be used to combine all this. Okay, in your textbook, one big table is the teacher ID is connected to all this. For example, C2H2. Look here, in this code, C2 then S1, C1, that kinds of code will be there. So that means S stands for science and C1 stands for commerce, then H2, and H2 means humanities. Okay, let us assume that. So you know each batch, they are having their own teachers. So we can combine all the teachers to this corresponding table. So the number of tuples will be extra. That means we are multiplying with this the same. That means if we are combining two tables together, that Cartesian product definition means relation consisting of all tuple combinations of tuples from two relation. It is a binary operation which has a number of actually what is mean by degree of a relation? Number of attributes in a relation is known as degree. Then what does mean by cardinality? Number of rows in a relation is known as cardinality. I think these two is common to you because that we are already studying, cardinality and also degree. Okay, so that you already know. Then Cartesian product operation means here it returns a relation consisting of all possible combinations of tuples of two relation. So when we are combining two tables together, then all possible combinations will come in Cartesian product operation. Cartesian product operation is used for Cartesian product, or one more name is a cross product. So the symbol that we are using for representing Cartesian product operation is cross. Okay, clear. So these are the four operations on relational algebra. So what is our first operation? So we will revise the topics that we studied. First operation, union operation. Union operation is used to combine two relations together. Then it uses the symbol U. Then intersection, same, it is used for intersecting two relation or combining two relation, and it uses the symbol intersection symbol. Then intersection means it is used to display the common values present in the both relation. Then set difference, the first relation, all the tuples from the first relation will be displayed, but the second relation will not be there. Then last one was Cartesian product operation. Okay, then hope you understood. Then you want to write one question in your notebook, that is you want to explain all these four relation with a suitable example. Okay, example is already given in your textbook. It's very easy. It's an easy topic. So by this, we are concluding this chapter, database management system. So in database management system, first we discussed about what does mean by database and need of database, conventional file system, advantages of database. And after that, we discussed about the different levels of abstraction, data independence. Then after that, relational algebra. In relational algebra, we are discussing about all the operations on relation. We started with select, then project, union, intersection, set difference, and last one was Cartesian product operation. Okay, hope you understood. Next chapter is a continuation of relational algebra. Actually, now we know what is relational algebra. So next we are going to deal with or interact with the relational algebra. For interacting with relational algebra, we need a communication language. That language is known as query language. So that we are going to discuss later. Okay, so hope you understood. The remaining section we will discuss in the next video. Okay, then.